Hi, hello, this is Giri. Teaching 10th Mathematics, the chapter Trigonometry. Questions and solutions from exercise 11.4, and this is part 1 video. In this video, we will learn the solutions of the 3 bits from the first question and the second question as well. Here is the question number 1. Evaluate the following. First bit, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta. I shall repeat. Evaluate the following. First bit, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta. We have given a question in an elaborated form. Now we have to find the value of this. Now let us find the value. Here is the solution. Here, now to solve this, first of all, let us write the question. Question is, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta. Now, as you can find tan theta, secant theta, cot theta and cosecant theta, let us write all these 4 trigonometrical ratios in terms of sine and cos. In terms of only 2 trigonometrical ratios, sine and cos. We know that tan theta is equal to sine theta by cos theta. And secant theta is 1 by cos theta, as secant theta is multiplicative inverse to cos theta. Similarly, cot theta is the multiplicative inverse of tan theta. Therefore, as you know that tan theta is sin theta by cos theta, you can write cot theta as cos theta by sin theta. Minus cosecant theta is the inverse trigonometrical ratio to sin, therefore it is 1 by sin theta. So that we wrote the question, we converted the question as 1 plus tan theta means sin theta by cos theta plus secant theta means 1 by cos theta into 1 plus cot theta means cos theta by sin theta minus cosecant theta means 1 by sin theta. Now look at the first bracket. In this first bracket we have 3 values. This is first value, this is the second value and it is the third value. You can write 1 as 1 by 1, so that these 3 are fractions. Now we have to add these 3 fractions. Wherever you go for addition of fractions, first of all you should find the LCM. Here the denominator is 1 by 1, the denominator is 1. Here the denominator is cos theta. Here the denominator is cos theta again. Therefore, the LCM of 1 cos theta and cos theta is cos theta only. Isn't it? Good. Now 1 into cos theta is cos theta plus, as the denominator and LCM is same, you may write the numerator as it is, sin theta plus, again denominator and LCM are same, therefore it is plus 1. When you simplify the first bracket, or if we add these 3 fractions, we got cos theta plus sin theta plus 1 divided by cos theta. So far we have 3 fractions. Now we made these 3 fractions into a single fraction, isn't it? Similarly, on the other side also, here if you observe this, again there are 3 fractions here. 1 means 1 by 1 plus cos theta by sin theta minus 1 by sin theta. Now let us make these 3 fractions into single fraction. Here 1 means 1 by 1, the denominator is 1. Here the denominator is sin theta. And in this case, the denominator is again sin theta. Then the LCM of 1 sin theta and sin theta is sin theta only. The numerator is 1 into sin theta is sin theta plus, as LCM and denominator are same, write cos theta. Again, LCM and denominator are same, write minus 1. You see, sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 divided by sin theta. Again, these 3 fractions are made into a single fraction. Now, this is one fraction. Whole this cos theta plus sin theta plus 1 is numerator and cos theta is denominator. And in the second fraction, sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 is numerator and sin theta is denominator. Now, these 2 are 2 fractions. We have to multiply these 2 fractions, isn't it? We have to multiply these 2 fractions. The product of 2 fractions is nothing but the product of the numerators by the product of the denominators. Means product of numerators, you have to multiply these 2 numerators. The first numerator is cos theta plus sin theta plus 1 and the second numerator is cos theta plus sin theta minus 1. Here, if you multiply these two, if you assume that cos theta plus sin theta is A and 1 is B, then this is in the form of A plus B into whole, this is A and minus B. A plus B into A minus B. What is A plus B into A minus B? Dear children, can you say what is A plus B into A minus B? Good. A plus B into A minus B is A square minus B square. A value means cos theta plus sin theta. A square means cos theta plus sin theta whole square. Minus B square means B square is 1 square. Divided by the product of denominators, cos theta into sin theta is cos theta into sin theta only. Now if you observe this, you can find cos theta plus sin theta whole square, which is in the form of A plus B whole square now. This is different from previous one. Previously, we have the formula A plus B into A minus B, which is A square minus B square. Now, this is in the form of A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square is A square plus B square plus 2AB, or A square plus 2AB plus B square also you can write. Anyhow, A plus B whole square means A square cos square theta plus B square plus sin square theta plus 2AB, 2 into cos theta into sin theta minus 1 square is 1 divided by cos theta into sin theta. From the Pythagorean trigonometrical identities, we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. You may please recollect the Pythagorean trigonometrical identities. There are 3 Pythagorean trigonometrical identities. Out of the 3, first one is cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. And the second is secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. And the third identity is cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. These 3 are called Pythagorean trigonometrical identities. These 3 are useful in solving all these problems of exercise 11.4. We already discussed about all these 3 Pythagorean trigonometrical identities in the introduction of this chapter trigonometry, where we learned the proof of the first Pythagorean identity also. Okay, anyhow, we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to this value is 1. Therefore, in the place of cos square theta plus sin square theta, write 1 plus 2 into sin theta into cos theta, 2 into sin theta into cos theta minus 1 divided by cos theta into sin theta. Now, what is 1 minus 1? 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 plus 2 sin theta cos theta, 2 sin theta cos theta divided by cos theta into sin theta. You can cancel cos theta and you can cancel sin theta so that this value, simplified value of this elaborated question is 2. So that we simplify the value of the first bit. Now look at the first question, second bit now. Here is the question. Evaluate second bit, cos theta plus sin theta whole square plus cos theta minus sin theta whole square. I shall repeat. Evaluate second bit, cos theta plus sin theta whole square plus cos theta minus sin theta whole square. This is in the form of A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square. Now let us see the solution now. First of all, let us write the question. The question is cos theta plus sin theta whole square, cos theta plus sin theta whole square plus cos theta minus sin theta whole square. The first bracket is in the form of A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square formula, A square plus 2AB plus B square. And the second bracket is in the form of cos theta minus sin theta whole square, that is A minus B whole square. A minus B whole square is A square minus 2AB plus B square. Now, if you apply A plus B whole square to the first bracket, cos theta plus sin theta whole square is A square cos square theta plus B square plus sin square theta plus 2AB plus 2 into cos theta into sin theta. Similarly, if we apply A minus B whole square formula to cos theta minus sin theta whole square, A minus B whole square is A square minus 2AB plus B square. Therefore, cos theta whole square is cos square theta plus B square sin square theta minus 2AB minus 2 cos theta into sin theta. Again, we just learned the Pythagorean trigonometrical identities. From this, cos square theta plus sin square theta value is 1. Okay? The green color value is equal to here green color 1. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. We know that cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1 from Pythagorean trigonometrical identities. Therefore, this value is 1. Similarly, here also you can find cos square theta plus sin square theta. Therefore, cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is in green color, is also equal to green color 1. Okay? Now, this value is 1 plus 2 cos theta sin theta plus this value is 1 minus 2 cos theta sin theta. Now, add 1 plus 1. What is 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 is 2. Plus 2 cos theta sin theta minus 2 cos theta sin theta may get cancelled. Or if you subtract 2 cos theta sin theta from the same 2 cos theta sin theta, you will get 0. What is 2 plus 0? 2 plus 0 is 2. So that we solve the second bit. We simplify the second bit. Whose value is equal to 2? Now, the same question, question number 1. Third bit now. Dear children, here is the third bit. I shall read the question. You please verify. Evaluate secant square theta minus 1 into cosecant square theta minus 1. I shall repeat. Evaluate secant square theta minus 1 into cosecant square theta minus 1. Now, let us see the solution. Secant square theta minus 1 into cosecant square theta minus 1. Wherever you find secant square theta, just you may recollect the trigonometrical identity which is having secant square theta as a term. That identity is the second trigonometrical identity. We know that secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. This is the second Pythagorean trigonometrical identity. From this, if you take this plus 1 to this side and minus tan square to the other side, then secant square theta minus 1 is equal to minus tan square theta other side plus tan square theta. Okay? Secant square theta minus 1 is equal to tan square theta. And next, if you observe this second bracket, it is cosecant square theta minus 1. Wherever you find cosecant square theta, then you may recollect the trigonometrical identity where cosecant theta is a term. That is, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. It is the third Pythagorean trigonometrical identity. From this, again, bring this plus 1 at RHS to LHS and minus cot square to RHS. So that this is cosecant square theta plus 1 this side is minus 1 is equal to minus cot square theta other side plus cot square theta. For the first bracket, secant square theta minus 1 value, you can replace it as tan square theta. And second bracket, secant cosecant square theta minus 1 can be replaced with cot square theta. Now let us simplify this. First of all, secant square theta minus 1 into cosecant square theta minus 1 is equal to this value is tan square theta into this value is cot square theta. But cot theta is the inverse, multiplicative inverse to tan. We know that tan theta is cos sin theta by cos theta, and whereas cot theta is cos theta by sin theta. One is the reciprocal of the second. Therefore, cot theta, you can write cot theta as 1 by tan theta. Cot theta is 1 by tan theta, and cot square theta is 1 by tan square theta. Therefore, this is tan square theta into cot square theta means 1 by tan square theta. This tan square theta in this tan square theta one time, therefore 1 into 1 is 1. And we simplified this bit also and we got the value 1. So that we concluded the question number 1. Now let us solve the question number 2. Here is the question number 2. Show that cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. I shall repeat. Show that cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. Here is the solution. Here you have to prove that LHS is equal to RHS. We have given an equation. We have to prove LHS is equal to RHS. LHS is cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square. Whereas RHS is 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. Now, in order to prove this, if you observe LHS, you can find cosecant theta and cot theta. Whereas if you observe RHS, you can find only cos theta. There is no other trigonometrical ratio. Therefore, let us convert this cosecant theta and cot theta in terms of cos theta and sin theta. Okay? Take LHS. LHS is equal to cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square. We know that the cosecant theta is the multiplicative inverse to sine. Therefore, in the place of cosecant theta, you can write 1 by sine theta minus cot theta is cos theta by sine theta whole square. Now we have two fractions. We have to subtract the second fraction from the first. Isn't it? Minus is there. We have to subtract. Therefore, the LCM of sine theta and sine theta is sine theta only. Numerator 1 minus cos theta by sine theta whole square. A fraction whole square is nothing but numerator whole square by denominator whole square. Numerator whole square means 1 minus cos theta whole square by denominator whole square means it is sine square theta. But if you observe the RHS, RHS contains only cos trigonometrical ratio. There is no other trigonometrical ratio except cos. Here in numerator cos is there, therefore you need not change this. But whereas if you observe the denominator, you can find sin theta. Therefore, this sin theta is to be converted in terms of cos theta. In order to convert sin theta into cos theta, you should go for the first Pythagorean identity. That is, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. From this, what is sin square theta? Take this plus cos square theta to other side, then sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. In the place of sin square theta, I shall write 1 minus cos square theta. If you observe this, 1 is nothing but 1 square minus cos square theta. You please observe, numerator and denominator are different. Numerator is whole square. 1 minus cos theta whole square is numerator, whereas denominator is 1 minus cos square theta. Both are different. Please verify. This is whole square. But whereas it is not whole square, it is only, the square is only to applicable to cos theta. Okay. Now you observe the denominator. Denominator is in the form of 1 minus cos square theta. You can write 1 as 1 square. 1 square is 1 only. Therefore, it is a square minus b square. Denominator is in the form of a square minus b square. If you expand this, you will get a plus b into a minus b. That is 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by a plus b into a minus b. That is 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Is it clear? Okay. Now 1 minus cos theta whole square means 1 minus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta divided by 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta. 1 1 minus cos theta at numerator and this 1 minus cos theta denominator may be get cancelled and 1 minus cos theta may remain at numerator and 1 plus cos theta may remain at denominator. Therefore, the final value of this is 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta, which is nothing but our RHS. You observe RHS is same, 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So that we took LHS, we substituted 1 by sin theta in terms of cosecant theta and cos theta by sin theta in the place of cot theta, and we simplified. On simplification, we changed the sin square theta also in terms of cos square theta, and finally we got the RHS, which is 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. Like this, we solved question number 2. Dear students, the video links of the introduction to this chapter and the solutions of all the problems from exercise 11.1, 11.2 and 11.3 are provided in the description. You can click them and you can revise the chapter whenever it is necessary. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda. Thank you.